You should not interrupt the treatment, do not stop it, and finish it completely. Hey there, welcome back to How to Medicate, and welcome to this new video on the antibiotic Mitronidazole. I already made several videos on antibiotics. You can find all of them in a playlist in the description or somewhere up there. Now, for those of you I'm meeting for the first time, my name is Raoul. I'm a medical doctor from the Netherlands, and I'm making weekly medical videos to educate myself as well as you, my viewer. Because here at How to Medicate, we believe that medically educated people make healthier decisions, and that's what we are all about. Now, this video also comes with a quick disclaimer. It's meant purely informative. This is not medical advice, and if you're looking for medical advice, always contact your own doctor. Now, quickly, let's get started. Now, the generic name of this medication is Mitronidazole, but it's sold under several brand names, Flagyl and Metrogyl. It's available as an ovule, which is a vaginal suppository, oral suspension, tablets, or injections. Now then, how do you use this antibiotic? If you want to take the tablets, take them with half a glass of water, just drink them, don't chew on them, don't break them, because this will make them less effective. If you want to use the oral suspension, shake the bottle before using it, measure the correct amount with a supplied measuring spoon or with a measuring cup. And if you want to use the ovule, it needs to be inserted deep into the vagina, and when laying on your back, you can easily do this yourself. Furthermore, it's best to take this antibiotic after you ate something. This will lower your chances of stomach complaints. In addition, always take this antibiotic at fixed times, preferably in the morning or in the evening. This will lower your chances of missing a dose. Now, the duration of treatment usually depends on the severity of the infection, the location of your infection, and so on, but usually it's between 1 to 10 days. Here, it's also important for me to mention that you should not interrupt the treatment. Do not stop it and finish it completely, even if your symptoms already have disappeared, because this doesn't mean the infection has disappeared as well. So finish your treatment. Mitronidazole is used in serious infections with a microorganism that is sensitive for mitronidazole, which makes sense. Now, the most common infections where mitronidazole is used are urinary tract infections, such as several STDs, some infections of your stomach and intestines, and it's often prescribed after someone had surgery, just out of precaution to prevent an infection. And this brings us to dosages. Now, it's important here to know that the correct dosage depends on many factors: your age, your weight, the location of the infection, severity of the infection, and so on. Therefore, it is very important you use the prescribed dosage and frequency your doctor gave you. Normally, in these videos, I would now provide you with some general guidelines, but for mitronidazole, I can't. The correct dosages differ too much depending on a specific infection. However, it is important here to know that sometimes a single dose of mitronidazole can be efficient to eradicate an infection. So if your doctor just prescribed you one dose, don't worry, it's normal and it will be effective. Now, mitronidazole is a very effective antibiotic, but unfortunately it can have some side effects. In this video, I will only discuss the most common ones, but if you're looking for a complete list, then check your leaflet or ask your prescribing physician. Commonly, 1 to 10% of all patients will experience increased sensitivity for additional infections. Uncommonly, so a tenth of a percent to 1% of all patients will experience general body weaknesses. And rarely, patients will experience severe allergic reaction and or convulsions. Now, regarding safety, mitronidazole is safe to combine with any type of food. However, you should not drive while using mitronidazole, as it can cause dizziness, which makes it dangerous to drive. Furthermore, it's also not advised to combine it with alcohol, as this can severely increase the side effects you might experience. So wait at least 2 days after taking your last dosage of mitronidazole before you start consuming alcohol. Furthermore, mitronidazole can have some serious interactions with other drugs, and it can be harmful for people with severe liver or neurological problems. Therefore, always contact your prescribing physician and ask them if mitronidazole is safe for you. As always in these videos, we end off by taking a look at the safety of mitronidazole when pregnant or when breastfeeding, and there is extensive medical experience which does not indicate any risks. Therefore, you could safely use mitronidazole while pregnant or while breastfeeding, but just to make sure, always contact your own doctor and ask them. Now, I hope you learned a lot, because educated people make healthier decisions, and that's the whole point of this channel. So if you do have any questions, let me know in the comment section and I will do my best to answer all of them. Furthermore, don't forget to subscribe. This will help out my channel tremendously and helps me to reach my new goal of 5K subscribers. Thank you for watching, and as always, I will see you next week with a new video. Till then, bye bye.